here today to help talk with us about breeders and puppy mills is Kathy Bassett. Mm-hmm. And she is Wayside Waif's canine advocate. Someone, just a few minutes ago when we were talking about this before we started rolling tape, you were talking about walking?
Walking. They have a difficult time walking. Some of them, depending on where they come from, now regulations are that they're supposed to be on a flooring that can be cleaned, but sometimes they won't be on a appropriate flooring, whether it be gravel or whether it be completely a wire pen, and it kind of deforms their feet, so they're not used to the flat surface that normal dogs walk on. So when they come into this facility and we put them on the floor, whether it's because they've been on that type of cage flooring, they can't maneuver themselves, or even sometimes it's they can't walk appropriately because it's been years that their toenails have been trimmed. You know, they're not like the average dog that we have at home where we keep them groomed and keep their nails trimmed and nice, and it's really sad.
Oh. So talk to me about animal behaviors and the difference between a puppy mill dog and the average dog that might be a stray or turned in from a family.
Generally, the type of the dogs that we see here are very friendly. They come in and they're social and they'll take treats from us and approach us, and their tails are wagging and they're really happy to see us. And these guys are just extremely terrified. You know, they're not used to so many people and they're not used to what's going on. They're just terrified, and they just shake, and they don't move. And you know, we kind of have this process when they come in, and we kind of look over them and we vaccinate them, and they're just really scared. You could virtually do anything to them. You could lay them on their back and they wouldn't even move. They're terrified. And a lot of times what we've noticed is once we put them back in the kennel, completely different dog.
Really?
Yes. So you can go into the kennel and you can sit down and you can interact with them. Some of them, when you get in there, they are still a bit fearful, but if you close that kennel door, they come right up to the bars and their tail is wagging and they're friendly because that's what they know. You know, you can kind of give them cookies through the door, but once you take them out of that kennel, it's completely different, and they just, you know, they don't know the normal things. They don't know what a vacuum is or what a TV is. So it's
well, this has been their world. These kennels have been their world, and that's all they know.
That's all they know.
So you're giving them an alien environment. And so how do you socialize them? How do you get them?
Well, we have lots of volunteers here and staff who will go in and sit with them. We'll take them into the grass. Some of them have never even seen grass before, so that's something completely new to them. We'll give them beds. Some of them never have seen that. The last puppy mill survivors is what we call them. We gave them toys, and they played for hours. It was so amazing to see an animal who is 5 years old and who has never seen a stuffed animal love it and play with it and toss it in the air and shake it and do all kinds of stuff. It's really amazing. So I think that, you know, as long as we're working with them and giving them the love and the attention that they need, we bring them out of their shell and they start to warm up and they start to realize that we're here to help them.
There is life after puppy mills.
Yep.
And so do you have any idea how many puppy mill dogs Wayside has placed?
I do not know. It has to be in the hundreds. I've been at this facility for 11 years and we bring them in all the time. And, you know, we counsel their new homes about what they'll need, and people are very open to it, and they're very understanding. And it almost is like they want to do it. They want to help this animal that's never had anything, so it's so great.
It's a very rewarding experience.
Yeah, it's very rewarding for us and them.
Oh,
so
thank you so much for your time.
Welcome.
We really appreciate it. This is Kathy Bassett at Wayside Waves.